Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cube, and you're hitting wait time on your data flows. What do we do about that? Do we just wait? What's going on? Let's dig in. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. All right, I've talked about this in some other videos before. I did a video on data flow refreshing and how this works, and I touched on it, but I'm worried that it got lost. And so what I want to do is talk about the wait time, what it means, and what can you do about it. All right, enough of all this talking. You know how we like to do it here in Guy in a Cube. Let's do what? Let's head over to my machine. So we've got a data flow. Let me come down here. My internet sales demo. Go to refresh history. You'll see, you know, the different refresh histories. There could be a scenario, and I apologize, I can't actually show it to you. It's actually hard to repro on my end without significant load. But one thing you may see is we see a commonality of like, hey, maybe it's going 5-10 minutes. That's the average. That's usually what we see. But every once in a while, you see one that takes like 40 minutes. Like, what the heck? Why is there one that's just way out there when everything else seems to be like 5-10 minutes? And what you can do, and this is what I love about data flows, is we can download the refresh history. And when we open that up, one thing we'll see here is an actual breakout of the duration, how many rows, bytes, max commit memory, and then processor time, you know, different breakouts and timing. So you can actually see what's going on. The other thing you'll see here is this wait time. The wait time is what we want to focus on here. In that example that I showed before, where we've got a bunch of them that are maybe, let's just say they're 5 minutes every time on average, and you've got one that's like 40 minutes. And so that 40 minute item, typically what I would expect to see in that type of scenario is your wait time is going to account for that extra 35 minutes. And so, okay, how do I adjust that? In that case, the data flow that had to wait 35 minutes, that data flow is the victim. It's not the cause. More than likely, because it didn't get to go yet. It had to wait until it could actually execute. So it's just being hit with this wait as a result of everything else that's running on the capacity. And so in this context, we're on a premium capacity. And what we need to realize here is that this is a resource issue on the capacity itself. Anytime you hit a resource issue on the capacity, you only have a few options. So the first one is optimize, right? Can we actually optimize the data flow and the other data flows in your system? Make sure they're all running at peak performance, make sure they're running as fast as they can so they're not consuming as much resources as they could, right? So we want them to go complete fast so that they get out of the way for other things to run and they're not chewing up all the CPU or the containers that are available or the memory, any of that stuff. The other thing to realize here is that it could also be impact from other workloads. So if you've got paginated workloads, if you got data set workloads, all of those things are consuming resources. So we want to make sure all of that is going as fast as possible. So it may be more than just optimizing data flows, maybe looking at the capacity holistically and seeing, okay, what else can we do? If you do all of that and we're still seeing the wait times, you only have two other options. One is scale out. So this means maybe the workspace that this data flow is in, moving it off to another workspace that's on a different capacity. And so making sure that it has more breathing room to go do what it needs to do. You may just actually be at the max line of what your capacity is. And so you've got to adjust that. The other thing that you can do is potentially scale up the capacity. So give it more resources to be able to do what you're trying to do on that capacity. Those are always going to be your three options whenever we talk about resource contention on a capacity. Even if you've got data set issues, those are your three options. You've got to do something there. So be mindful of that and make sure that everything is the best that it can be with inside of that capacity. Not a super long video, but a pretty important one and a point that I think everyone needs to realize when we're monitoring and managing premium capacity. Everything needs to run fast, right? So make sure everything's as optimized as it can and then deal with your options for scaling up or scaling out. All right, let me know what you think down in the comments below. I would love to hear it. Do you have other thoughts and other things that you've seen when it comes to wait time on data flows? Or do you just wait? Maybe you didn't even notice it was there. Let me know down below. I want to hear it. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button. Smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.